So previously we saw that in the ASK we are transmitting symbols in the direction of the cosine, and in the PSK we are transmitting the symbols on a circle where the amplitude is constant and we are changing only the phase. But some people said that since in the ASK we are using only one dimension out of two dimensions, we have two dimension figure and we are transmitting the symbols only on one dimension, this might not be efficient. And then if we look at the PSK, apparently we are using the two dimensions, we are using the two directions, cosine and sine. So this is, apparently we are using, in the PSK we are using two dimensions, right? But this is actually not true, because although you are using the two dimensions here, actually you are going on a circle. Your, all the points, all the constellation signals, or all the constellation points are on a circle. They are not free to move anywhere in the two dimensions. And if you look at the polar coordinates, you will find that actually in the PSK you are moving on one dimension only. So although it looks like it might trick you and it looks like you are using the two dimensions here, actually you are using only one dimension here in the PSK, because if you move to the polar coordinates, you will find that r, or the radius, is constant and theta is the only dimension that is changing. So here also we are using one dimension. Then they said, okay, in order to be more efficient, why don't we use both dimensions? So what we can do, they said we can do something similar to the quadrature amplitude modulation that we studied in the NL. And this is exactly what we are doing here. The quadrature amplitude modulation, they said, okay, since we have sine and cosine and these two functions are orthogonal to each other, what we can do, we can transmit some bits on the cosine direction and some other bits on the sine direction, and that the receiver, since these two functions, cosine and sine, they are orthogonal, will be able to spread them at the receiver. So they said, if we have these two directions, this is cosine, omega ct, and this is minus sine, omega ct, they said, okay, we can have four, let's say, as an example, four amplitudes in the direction of cosine. Let's say a over 2, 3a over 2, and minus a over 2, minus 3a over 2. Same thing, we can have four amplitudes in the direction of sine, a over 2. Not necessarily the same, but usually this is the case. 3a over 2 minus a over 2 minus 3a over 2. Again, the number in the direction of cosine and the number in the direction of sine, not necessarily to be the same, not necessarily 4 amplitudes and 4 amplitudes, they can be different. But usually they have square constellation, this is more efficient in terms of power. But they said, okay, we have 4 amplitudes now, which means 4 area in the direction of the cosine and 4 area in the direction of the sine. This will give us a quadrature amplitude modulation of sine 16, because we have 4 options in the cosine, 4 options in the sine. So basically what you can do is you can transmit this amplitude in the cosine and this amplitude in sine. This will give you one option, a over 2 in the cosine and 3a over 2 in the direction of sine. This is another option. So this is a constellation point, this is another constellation point. 3a over 2 in cosine and a over 2 in sine. This is another option, a fourth option. So in this quadrant we have 4 options. We can do the same here. This with this will give you one constellation point, another constellation point, and so on. So we get 16 different combinations, 16 different constellation points, right? So this is what we call 16 quem. This is just an example, huh? This is just an example of 16 quem. Of course, 16 can be 64, can be anything, right? So this is an example of 16 quem. And then, since we have 16 different constellation points, each constellation point can carry up to 4 bits. And they can distribute the bits according to any coding scheme, for example, gray coding or any other coding scheme. But one thing is that you can let the cosine carry two bits and the sine carry two bits, because the cosine has four amplitudes, so each amplitude of the cosine direction can carry four bits. For example, we can assign 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0 in the amplitudes of the cosine, and for the amplitudes of the sine, we can also assign 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, and then these two bits of the cosine, they can represent the least two bits, and the two bits of the sine, they can represent the upper two bits. For example, if you want to transmit this constellation point, it will be 0, 1, 0, 1. This constellation point, it will be 0, 1 from the sine direction and 0, 0 from the cosine direction. Here, for this point, it will be 0, 0 from the sine and 0, 1. This point will be 0, 0, 0, 0, and so on. You can continue doing this for all points, and each point will carry four different bits. You will notice here in the QAM that when you move from one constellation point to another constellation point, you are not only doing amplitude modulation, you are also doing phase modulation, right? Because you are, when you change from one point to another point, you change the amplitude and you change the phase. So you can't always write the QAM signal as some magnitude AI multiplied by cosine plus some magnitude BI multiplied by sine. And by the way, something that we need to say here at this point is that we assume that we have rectangular pulses in all modulation schemes that we talked about. But this is not necessarily true. You can use any of the pulse shapes that we learned before, right? You can use Nyquist first criteria pulses, Nyquist second criteria pulses. You can use any of the pulses, and you can, in the equations, you can put the pulses here. You can multiply by the pulses like this. So this is how you represent the QAM signal. You have a certain magnitude in the cosine, certain magnitude in the sine, and you can combine these two magnitudes, and you say that you are transmitting some radius Ri cosine omega ct plus theta I. Okay, so each constellation point, it has a different magnitude and a different phase. So here in the QAM is considered to be both amplitude modulation and phase modulation. You are doing amplitude modulation and phase modulation. This is clear. When you move from one point to another point, you change magnitude and you change the phase together. So this is the QAM. In the QAM, we are using the two dimensions efficiently. Okay, this is how you write it mathematically. And you can increase, using the QAM, you can increase the number of bits that you that are carried by each signal. However, in the QAM, for sure, we have to use coherent detection. So in the QAM, you have to use coherent detection. And this is something that we know since we use the QAM in the analog transmission. Okay, so that was the last modulation technique. We talked about ASK, PSK, FSK, and finally we talked about M-ARI QAM, and we took an example of 16 QAM, so usually we write it as M-ARI QAM. We can write it as 16 ARI QAM, but usually we write it directly as 16 QAM. So they write it as M-ARI QAM or M-QAM, doesn't matter. Okay, so that's it for this video. We'll stop here and see you in the next video.